Now, this is the first part of the question. A 23-year-old primi gravida at 39 weeks with complaint of leaking of fluid for one day, right? So there is leaking PV. She is 39 weeks. She's primi, fine. She is getting mild pains for the past 4 hours. She was treated for UTI in the second trimester. Her temperature is 100.7, so she has fever. BP is 120 by 68, that's fine. Pulse is 100 per minute, so she has tachycardia, that's because of the fever, of course. Abdominal examination shows diffuse uterine tenderness. The cervix is 2 cm dilated and pooling of clear fluid in the vagina is seen. So our diagnosis of leaking PV is confirmed. Microscopy of the vaginal fluid shows ferning. So any doubt about leaking has been confirmed. So she is, yes, leaking PV. The fetal heart rate is 170 per minute. So there's fetal tachycardia also. She is getting mild contractions. Initial lab tests show HP of 10.2 and a total leukocyte count of 20,000 per mmq. Which is the most likely diagnosis? Is it placental abruption? In case of placental abruption, yes, there can be fetal tachycardia also. More likely, there will be fetal distress. Diffuse uterine tenderness is also there in placental abruption. But in this particular case, what has happened? There is no complaint of vaginal bleeding. There is no relevant clinical history that is signifying that she is having a placental abruption. No history of trauma, no history of hypertension. So placental abruption is not the answer here. All right. What about PID? There is no significant finding of PID also. There is no unhealthy vaginal discharge, no foul-smelling vaginal discharge history, or there is no factor which is saying that she could have had a PID earlier. So PID, pelvic inflammatory disease, is also not the answer. What about pyelonephritis? Could it be pyelonephritis? She has a history of UTI in the second trimester, but she was treated for it, right? But there are no urinary symptoms that are being mentioned here. There is no renal angle tenderness which is being mentioned here, right? And why would there be diffuse uterine tenderness in a pyelonephritis case? So pyelonephritis is also not the answer here. But the clinical picture is classically fitting what? Intra-amniotic infection. Yes, it is fitting chorioamnionitis. The fact that she has had leaking for one day. So 24 hours have gone by, prolonged leaking, right? Now she has started pains in the past 4 hours, fine, but prolonged leaking is there. Fever is there. Diffuse uterine tenderness is there. Fetal tachycardia is there, right? Raised leukocyte count is there. So all is, the clinical setting is signifying that there is intra-amniotic infection or chorioamnionitis. So answer is option number B. Now look at the second part of the question. In addition to broad spectrum antibiotics, obviously there is intra-uterine infection, so you will start broad spectrum antibiotics. Which of the following is the most appropriate next step in management of this patient? Should you administer corticosteroids? Why? That it is not preterm, right? So, woman is 39 weeks. So, corticosteroids are not given. And moreover, corticosteroids in the presence of frank chorioamnionitis can flare up the infection, right? So, administering corticosteroids is not to be done. Will you go for expectant management? What do you think? Should we just wait and watch? No, Baba, she's having fever, fetal tachycardia, and prolonged leaking. No role of expectant management at all. So we know that, yes, we need to deliver the woman, okay? We need to deliver the woman. That is for certain. But the question arises, should we do oxytocin augmentation of labor? Because as per the question, she is already in labor, right? Isn't it? She's already 2 cm dilated. She is getting uterine contractions, all right? So she's already in labor. So should we augment with oxytocin or should we go for a direct cesarean section? There is no need, there is no indication of going for a direct cesarean delivery. You start antibiotics, you give her IV fluids, you give her antipyretics and fever control, and we augment. Okay, so we administer oxytocin. There is no indication of doing a direct cesarean delivery as of now. So administering oxytocin to augment the labor? That is what the answer is going to be.